In this video, we'll talk about the similarities and differences between gametogenesis in males and females in humans. Gametogenesis is the term used to describe the formation of the gametes. So, gametogenesis. Is the production of gametes. Human gametes are haploid cells that develop by meiosis. There are two different forms of gametogenesis. We call the formation of egg cells oogenesis. And this occurs within the ovaries within human females. The process of oogenesis actually begins within the ovaries of the female before her birth. So at the time of her birth, all of the primary oocytes that she will have for her entire life will be present. Primary oocytes are diploid cells that have been fated to undergo meiosis. In fact, they even start this process of meiosis, but they're arrested in prophase 1 of meiosis 1, and they will remain that way until the female reaches puberty. Then, from puberty through menopause, each ovarian cycle, one or a few of these primary oocytes will be released from the paused state in which they're in. The first round of meiosis will occur, and the follicle surrounding that egg cell will mature and develop, as the egg cell also develops. The secondary oocyte will begin the process of meiosis II, and in fact it will go until it is arrested at metaphase of meiosis II, at which point it will be released from the ovary in a process known as ovulation. The oocyte will only complete meiosis II if a sperm cell comes in contact with it, and in that process of the sperm cell fertilizing the egg will quickly finish its second division of meiosis and then have a haploid nucleus. Now, one thing that's interesting, during these meiotic divisions of the oocytes, there will be an even division of the genetic material, but the cytoplasm will be divided very unevenly. So after this first division, the primary oocyte will be divided into what's known as a secondary oocyte, which is a very large cell that contains most of the cytoplasm of that previous cell, and a polar body. That polar body will have very little cytoplasm and will play no further role in development. A second polar body will be produced at the end of meiosis II, provided that there was fertilization of the egg cell by a sperm cell. That second polar body likewise plays no further role in development. When we compare this with spermatogenesis, spermatogenesis occurs within the testes, and it does not occur until the male reaches puberty. At that point, diploid precursor cells will divide via mitosis and give rise to the primary spermatocytes. These are the diploid cells that are fated to undergo meiosis. The first division of meiosis will result in two even cells, each containing half the genetic material of the primary spermatocyte and half the cytoplasm of that primary spermatocyte. These secondary spermatocytes are the cells that will then undergo meiosis II. In the second meiotic division, those two haploid cells will divide into a total of four cells. And those four cells will then mature through a process known as differentiation to become active sperm cells. In this way, each primary spermatocyte will end up resulting in four sperm cells capable of fertilizing an egg. In this way, hundreds and millions of sperm are produced each day, from puberty through the rest of the male's life. This production of sperm is optimized at temperatures below core body temperature, which is why the testes are external structures. So let's compare these two processes, oogenesis and spermatogenesis. Both of them occur in the gonads. Both of them start with diploid precursor cells. In both cases, those diploid precursor cells become fated to undergo the process of meiosis, and we call these the primary cells, the primary spermatocyte, and the primary oocyte. Now, the timing of when the primary cells are formed is different between males and females. In females, this happens before her birth, and all the primary oocytes she will have will be in her ovaries before the time of her birth. whereas for males, they do not start producing primary spermatocytes until they reach puberty. Those primary cells will undergo the first division of meiosis, known as meiosis I. In spermatogenesis, the primary spermatocyte becomes two evenly divided secondary spermatocytes. Yet, in meiosis I, the number of chromosomes is cut in half, going from a diploid cell to haploid cells. When we look at oogenesis, there's an even division of the genetic material during meiosis I, but a very uneven division of the cytoplasm. In fact, the difference is even greater than that which we see in this diagram. The secondary oocyte can even be thousands of times larger than that first polar body. The polar bodies play no further role in development. These secondary cells are then the cells that will undergo meiosis II. The two secondary spermatocytes will result in a total of four sperm cells. And those four sperm cells each can mature to a point where they would be capable of fertilizing an egg. Only the secondary oocyte will undergo meiosis II in oogenesis, and again will have an even division of the genetic material, but a very uneven division of the cytoplasm, resulting in a second polar body that plays no further role in development, and an enormous egg cell. The egg cell is many thousand times larger than a single sperm cell. In fact, the human egg cell is one of the largest human cells, with one of the greatest volumes of cytoplasm of any human cell. Hundreds of millions of sperm are produced on a daily basis in a typical adult human male, whereas in a typical adult human female, once every ovarian cycle, one egg is successfully developed and released. Now, there will be some variance here in both the length of the ovarian cycle and also the total number of eggs released, but typically it's one fertilizable egg in every approximately 28-day cycle. In the next video, we're going to talk about the female reproductive cycle, and we'll see how that process produces an egg cell and prepares that egg cell for possible fertilization. See you in the next video.